Because this process of habituation is actually supported, thank you, sponsored by, yes, none other than your brain's neuroplasticity, meaning that your brain is able to adapt and make new changes in connection with your tinnitus. Yeah, hello and welcome back to a new video on my channel, the Tinnitus Habituation Channel. The channel on which I, Frieder, person born deaf on this ear, with a severe tinnitus and a hearing aid on his other ear, tells you all about how habituation can save your ass from all the ringing. Yeah, and today I want to get into a little bit the fact that habituation and neuroplasticity are very much linked. Yeah? So you hear a lot about, okay, this neuroplasticity, how does it actually work? What does habituation and neuroplasticity? I actually have to do with tinnitus. And it's very, very funny because both terms are widely used and many people don't maybe really understand how they go together. And something that I come across quite often is that people don't even understand the term of habituation, where basically the ringing, hissing, whatever you might experience on your tinnitus becomes so much quieter, so it goes back into a place where it's barely noticeable. And also because you are so much more relaxed about it, not constantly freaking out about it, you're sending a powerful message to your brain that this stimulus is not worth focusing on all of the time. So your brain basically tags it as something non-dangerous and it goes more into the background, ergo you hear it less and less. But there's a lot more than this, because this process of habituation is actually supported, thank you, sponsored by, yes, none other than your brain's neuroplasticity, meaning that your brain is able to adapt and make new changes in connection with your tinnitus. But let's dive into how neuroplasticity and tinnitus actually function together and why neuroplasticity can help you to change the way you perceive tinnitus and get closer to habituation. The brain superpower, neuroplasticity, is basically our brain's ability to adapt and change. Yeah, it's like rewires itself throughout our lives. It basically always adapts to new conditions, different stimuli, different episodes and lifetimes that we're in. So basically your brain is very plastic and it's very useful for us, right? Because as a kid, your brain is developing a lot, you're learning a lot, it needs to form new connections. Now that gets a little bit more difficult as the older we become, but your brain never stops being plastic. Meaning that someone who has a very big difficulty and is feeling like they would never overcome it, in fact, actually the brain has the full ability to include all of these changes, make all of these changes, and adapt to new situations. Yeah. Plasticity sweeps in a little bit like a superhero rescuing you in your story and saves the day when you feel like, oh, I don't know how to do this. But you must be very careful saying that this is a process that you can influence, because not all of it is influenceable with you. So let's get into how habituation and neuroplasticity are basically connected. Before we get into that, however, I would say it's very, very important that we understand that if you haven't visited a doctor yet regarding your tinnitus or an audiologist, please make sure that you do that. I am a coach and I've been working with hundreds of people worldwide using the concepts of cognitive behavior therapy and acceptance and commitment therapy, and many other in between, based on my own experience with being deaf on one ear and having tinnitus and a hearing aid on the other ear. So I've been working with a lot of people, helping them to overcome tinnitus and getting habituated to their tinnitus. But it's very important that you make sure that your tinnitus is something absolutely safe you can experience and that you can then habituate to. So habituation is a process by which our brain becomes accustomed to the ringing, so it is not tagged as something dangerous anymore. And then it's much more easier for your brain to also just simply disregard it, right? It's a little bit like getting accustomed to a noisy neighbor who is always doing that one certain thing and it always bothers you. But after a while, actually, even if still he still continues doing the things, you never even hear it anymore because you're so used to it. It's not presented anymore. So it's very, very important that your brain has these plastic abilities to change the way it relates to tinnitus. But what do we have to change in order to get there? We basically, just saying, this is the right time for a short sequence about our online tinnitus management platform, because there were just two pings about someone commenting in our tinnitus venting space. Our tinnitus venting space in the community, which is www.mytinnitus.club, is a space where you can vent your frustration, anger, anything you experience, difficult time in connection with your tinnitus. You can go and vent constructively, because what you do when you vent is you create a potential for change. You vent anger and frustration, and for me or for other people in the community, that will show you that you have certain patterns in which you react to your tinnitus, in which you relate to your tinnitus, that's keeping you from habituation. So I designed a space inside our community. It's called the Tinnitus Venting Space, where you can go vent your anger and frustration and then get constructive criticism and feedback from the people in the community, from myself as a coach, so you can get closer to that process of habituation. But let's get back into neuroplasticity and habituation. So what is one of the most important core components? And I just mentioned it in the short excursion into the community venting space. One of the most important things is how we react and think about tinnitus, because that governs how we feel in response to our tinnitus. And when we feel something, very clearly it becomes very quickly reality. So very surely the tinnitus must be terribly dangerous and we have a terrible problem with it and it's going to be there for the rest of our lives, very difficult, and so on and so forth. You get me. So what stands between you and your neuroplastic changes towards habituation is the way you continuously react to tinnitus. And I'm not saying that's something that you're doing on purpose, but it is something that has become ingrained through you experiencing tinnitus as something negative and dangerous in your life. Take my example, yeah? I'm deaf on this ear. I have a loud ringing tinnitus and a hearing aid in this ear, which when he spikes, I can hear it. I mean, I hear it all the time anyways, but if he spikes, for example, I'm going on an 8-lane street, I can still hear it. Yeah? So the one difference though is I know that is the absolute normal for me to experience that. And that doesn't make me weird or terrible or something. But most people who experience tinnitus, and by the way, that's a lot, it's 20 to 30% of the population, they are habituated. And there's a reason for why most people with tinnitus who have a difficulty are in these forums, and the people who don't have a difficulty with tinnitus, they don't bother to go anywhere anymore because they're habituated. So in order to understand how you get to habituation, there are a few things that you can do. You can go and use the tools of cognitive behavior therapy, as we have them in the community as well, the ABC model. See how the ABC model influences your thoughts, emotions, and feelings with tinnitus, how you relate to it, and how that makes you reactive around your tinnitus, creating that vicious cycle of thinking about it, looking for it, hearing it, getting upset about it, and so on and so forth. Another one is fantastic, the acceptance and commitment therapy, which is basically something that's also used for spidophobia, fear of heights, and so on and so forth. And it's a fantastic tool to allow your brain to slowly but steadily disregard tinnitus, stop regarding tinnitus as something dangerous. So those neuroplastic changes, they can start to adapt while you adapt your behavior to tinnitus, basically. And today, I just want to share one extra tip that I like to give a lot of the people I work with and the people in the community. Persistence and persistence are the key to success. Taking a step back, realizing when tinnitus kicks in and annoys you and you become really upset about it, on how much that actually, what's going on really on a rational level versus what's going on in automatic mode, might sometimes make all the difference. So what I want to say to you is the key results of having habituation and neuroplasticity work for you, yeah, so that you get habituated and that neuroplasticity, neuroplastic changes can form itself, you need to first observe and learn to get to know your reaction. And in that, you need to be persistent. You need to know where to start, you need to know how to look, and you need to know when to be analyzing your reaction and then also realizing maybe I reacted a little bit stronger than I had to right now, right? So those are key. And I would like to say one of the things that I say to all the people as well, be kind, trust in the process. If you need any kind of help, there are three things that you can do after watching this video in the comments. Read my first guide, schedule a quick 15-minute call with me, or directly come into our community for 2 weeks free trial, get into the venting space, get into our habituation accountability check-in where we set goals every 2 weeks for every individual in the community if they want to, and then have 2 weeks time to really compare yourself against those goals, make them happen so you can build that neuroplastic changes in your brain towards habituation. So if that sounds good for you, I'd be happy for you to check out the resources that I have linked under the video or join us under www.mytinnitus.club. I hope it was a good and useful video for you. I wish you all the best, and I'll see you in the next one. From my heart to yours, from Berlin and Germany to wherever you are in the world, I wish you all the best and a lot of success with these strategies towards habituation. Thank you.